And welcome back to my channel, and good morning. A brisk 29 degree morning, so you can definitely tell it's November. So today's video is going to be all about Model A overdrives. So what we're going to do today is on the way over to my old man's place, I'm going to show you how an overdrive works in one of these two cars that have overdrive. And then once we get there, we're having a club seminar and we're going to be installing an overdrive in one of the club members' cars. Now this club member, he went all out. He bought the Mitchell overdrive and he bought the Mitchell synchronized transmission. So we're going to pull the rear in, we're going to pull the transmission, we're going to pull the clutch housing, because while you got that far apart, you may as well just throw a new clutch in it too. So we're going to replace the clutch, whole new tranny, install an overdrive, and all that stuff. And then I'm going to kind of show you some of the projects we're going to be working on this winter, since most of the project cars and stuff are at his house, which is about an hour and 5 minute drive away from here, hour and 10 minutes or so. I'll show you all the stuff that we do most of the stuff over there. So we're going to get one of these two guys out and we're going to head over there right now. Since both of these Model A's have overdrive, I have to decide which one I'm going to take today to show you how an overdrive works. And there's only really one fair way to do it, right? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a politician by the wallet. If he's caught, give him life. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. You're it. When you see an overdrive installed in a Model A, you'll see an extra lever. Sometimes people install a little handle that goes on the steering column, and that's not really the cool way to do it. This is the cool way to do it. So the Mitchell installations, you see the knob there. So you've got high up here, neutral, and low. The Mitchell overdrives are synchronized, even though your transmission may not be. There's a synchronization on this that's decent. Let me show you what it looks like under the car. So what happens when you install an overdrive in a Model A is you break the torque tube here, and then this box with fins goes in between. And yeah, I painted my overdrive. I like to do that just so it's not so ugly and obvious that it's there. Anyway, so that box goes in line with the torque tube, and now there's two shafts, one input and one output shaft, instead of just a straight through drive shaft. And the overdrive is what gives you, in this case, 26% overdrive gearing. I'll show you the linkage on the other side. Welcome to the underbelly of my two-door sedan. Sorry, it's a little dirty. So there's the overdrive box, and I can't quite get it, but if you look close, here's the linkage right here that shifts the overdrive. This just goes in and out, this shaft here. So there's the linkage back to kind of a bell crank thing. Now with the light on, now you can really see how dirty my car is underneath. Anyway, this connects to the shaft that is controlled by that lever inside the car, and this shifts back and forth, and that's what shifts this for the overdrive in and out. And yes, I painted my linkage just so that's not ugly either. Anyway, that's basically how it works. Nothing real fancy. Just getting installed is kind of a chore, so let's go get that done.
Overdrive works in any gear, including reverse. Some of the overdrives, like the Borg Warner, if you put it in reverse, you turn it into, I don't know, gear salad or something. But the Mitchell overdrive will work in any gear. So, going down this hill, for instance, I'm going to use all engine braking down this hill. I don't want to use up my brakes. So I can either go down this hill at 15 miles an hour, or second over is your friend. Now I can go down this hill at 25 miles per hour, which is the speed limit, and still get good engine braking. Okay, so I demonstrated second over, my favorite gear. Figure we'll get that one out of the way. Now I'm going to show you what happens, the magic that happens when you're in top gear, or third gear in a Model A, switch into overdrive. The magic speed for a Model A seems to be about 40 miles per hour without an overdrive. Once we get up to about 45, we'll switch into overdrive and watch. It's going to be magic from there on out. There's 45. Shift into overdrive. Magic. Everything gets quiet. Okay, so you got to make a turn here and then get on the state highway. Those of you who have a Model A with the stock gears, you know that first gear's here, second gear's here, and third gear's like way over here in the RPM range. There's this big gap between second and third gear. And especially when you're climbing a hill, that's where you really notice. As you come out of second, you're all revved up, you go to third, and it bogs down. And you're like, oh, come on, baby. Almost ready to go back to second. So here's what I'm going to do. This turn for me, when I get onto the state highway, is an uphill, and you have to accelerate. I'm going to show you what it's like to do it with and without overdrive. First, we're going to do it without.
Safe. That's totally safe. What? What? That's totally safe. Hi, cronies.
All right.
7/16. Yeah, trying. So it keeps getting stuck.
Okay, I'm ready. Time is money.
Put those on.
You ready?
Huh. Those are what
I was asking
you. All right, she's out. All right. You want that part or this part?
Is that linkage just still hooked up? What? No?
No. It's going to come out. You'll see.
I understand.
I just need somebody to hold the front end when I pull this out.
It'll go clunk?
Yeah, it'll go clunk. This is the part where we're supposed to have the jack stands under it, I think.
Right?
Yeah. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Let's go. Hang on.
Ouch.
Yep, got her. Let her go. Thank you. All right, here we go. Come here. Come on, pop. All right. Yep, that's how it works, eh?
Your bumper.
It makes it so much easier.
Oh, yes. Slide that jack under it, under the spring. Right there.
Spring?
Yep, just come up a little bit.
We have to do some editing.
About
here.
There.
Good.
Ta-da!
Here we go.
All right.
Are we just going to shut the jack?
Here it is. All the goodies. These are all the goodies, the new tranny.
Well, it will be. As soon as I get out of here, position them.
Touched it. Electronic ignition.
Well, I would take this under that off. Now is the outside.
Well, those nuts are made for one way.
Here, bend that down where you're
while we're at it.
I'm
going to
take the putting nut off. Get the hammer out again.
I mean, I see five people looking at it.
I do too.
Six.
Safely back home. Now, I realized that I didn't follow through with the complete installation of the overdrive, the transmission. You know what I discovered? And I'm pretty new to YouTube. I'm just kind of figuring this out. But I just discovered that club seminars make lousy YouTube videos. So what happens is everybody, you know, we're all working on the car, we're all trying to get the stuff done, and then you're trying to, no, hang on, I got to set up this shot, I got to get, and they don't want to wait. Everybody just wants to get this project done and get the car, and you got 10 guys standing around, you know, waiting for you to set up a camera. They get kind of, I don't know, let's just say impatient. So here's what I'm going to do. So at least you got to see kind of the setup of how we do it and how we got the car set up and how we kind of divvy up the responsibilities. I did talk to another club member who does want an overdrive, and he wants to put one in his car. In fact, it's a car that I sold him a while back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to work a deal where I can get that car to my shop for about a week. And then I can do it, and I can do a proper video and show you exactly how to install an overdrive step by step, not at a club seminar, because that is really not the place to do it. So give me a mulligan on that one, if you don't mind. I've done a lot of other good stuff, right? Anyway, thanks again for watching. Next video is going to be a totally different kind of video, and it'll at least be worth your time. So anyway, thanks again for sticking with me, and God bless. I'll catch you on the next video.